Hello everyone. Once again, welcome back to another session of Community Health and Social Work. In our previous video lectures, we had discussed about what is parasites, what are the infection or what are the causes which are related with parasite infection. And also we had discussed about what are the diseases related with parasites infection. And we had discussed about the malaria disease and the causes, the risk factors, the symptoms and the preventions and treatments in malaria disease. And now in this lecture, we will discuss about the intestinal worms, and we will discuss on briefly the causes, the symptoms, the risk factors, what are the complications in intestinal worms disease, and how we can prevent or what are the treatments for cure the intestinal worms disease, and what are the treatments available in hospital sectors for the person, those who are suffering from intestinal worms disease. Let's discuss on that briefly. First, we will discuss about what are intestinal worms. Intestinal worms, also known as parasitic worms, are one of the main type of intestinal parasites. Common types of intestinal worms include, what are the common different types of intestinal worms? Flatworms, which include tapeworms and flukes, roundworms, which cause ascariasis, pinworm and hookworm infections. These are the different types of intestinal worms. And what are intestinal worms actually? And intestinal worms are known as parasitic worms. These are the parasites through which a person is suffered or a person is infected through different types of parasites, and when that parasites developed, that person is infected by different types of parasites, this disease is known as intestinal worms, which are related with the worms infection. And there is different types of worms like hookworm, pinworm. There is different types of worms which are caused different diseases for a person due to different parasites infections. Next, we will discuss about different symptoms which are related with intestinal worms, or when a person is suffering from intestinal worms disease, and what are the signs through which we can detect that person is suffering from intestinal worms infection. Common symptoms of intestinal worms are abdominal pain, diarrhea, nausea or vomiting, gas or bloating, fatigue, unexplained weight loss, abdominal pain or tenderness. These are the common symptoms. Some persons have abdominal pain, some person have diarrhea, nausea or vomiting at a time of dysentery, or some persons have body pain or joint pain, and some have gastric problem or bloating, and sometimes some persons have weight loss very quickly. And these are the symptoms through which we can detect or we can diagnose a person is suffering from intestinal worms, or a person is infected through any type of parasite which causes the intestinal worms. A person with intestinal worms may also experience of dysentery. Dysentery is when an intestinal infection causes diarrhea with blood and mucus in the stool. Some persons have experience of dysentery at the time of intestinal worms infection. And when a person is suffering from dysentery that person have diarrhea with blood and also mucus in the stool, and through which we can detect that person is infected by any type of worm. Intestinal worms can also cause a rash or itching around the rectum or vulva. Sometimes some persons have rashes or itching problem in skin when a person is infected by intestinal worms. In some cases, you will pass a worm in your stool during a bowel movement, and sometimes they can discharge from the body directly, and some people may have intestinal worms for years without experiencing any symptoms. And some persons have intestinal worm infection for years, but there is no experience of any symptoms. Next, we will discuss about different causes of intestinal worms, or what are the reasons behind intestinal worms infection. One way to become infected with intestinal worms is eating undercooked meat from an infected animal such as a cow, pig or fish. When a person is taking food or eating undercooked meat which meat is from any animal, as such a cow, pig, or fish, and which is undercooked or which is half cooked. And when we are taking that type of food, there is a symptom or there is the reason of infection of intestinal worms. Other possible causes leading to intestinal worm infection, and there is some other possible causes also, which include consumption of contaminated water, consumption of contaminated soil, contact with contaminated fishes. Poor sanitation and poor hygiene. There is some other causes also, like when we are taking any drinking water, or that drinking water is very impure, we are not taking pure drinking water, we are not taking proper food, we are taking impure food or which is half cooked, and when we have direct contact with contaminated soil or which area is infected by any intestinal worms, and when we have contact with this soil, then there is also risk of infection of intestinal worms. And if we are not maintaining proper hygienic environment, if we are not staying in proper hygienic environment, or we are living in very poor sanitized area, that are the different causes of intestinal worms. And we have to maintain proper sanitized environment, hygienic environment for living our life or for a healthy life. Roundworms are typically transmitted through contact with contaminated soil and feces. And when a person is infected by roundworm, there is the typically these roundworms transmitted through contact with the soil. If soil infected by any parasite, then that person has contact with the soil, the person will be infected by these roundworms. Once you have consumed the contaminated substance, the parasite travels into your intestine. If you have consumed any contaminated substance or food or drinking water, then the parasites travels into your body or into your intestine. Then they reproduce and grow in the intestine. Once they reproduce and become larger in amount and size, symptoms may appear. When the parasites entered into the intestine, and when the parasites are reproduce or grow in the intestine, then they reproduce and they becoming larger in amount and in size also. After that, some persons have symptoms can appear, through which we can detect that person is suffering from infection by intestinal worms. Next, we will discuss about different risk factors, or what are the risk factors when a person is infected by the worms or infected by any intestinal worms. Children are particularly susceptible to intestinal worms. That's because they may play in environments with contaminated soil, such as sandboxes and school playgrounds. Older adults are also at increased risk due to weakened immune system. According to the World Health Organization, or WHO, about 10% trusted source of people in the developing world are infected with intestinal worms. People in developing countries are at the highest risk due to drinking water from contaminated sources and because of decreased sanitation level. When children are playing in any playground or any sandboxes, then they have contact with the contaminated soil. And when the children have direct contact with contaminated soil, there is the risk factors of intestinal worms infection for them. And when the children have contact with the impure or poor sanitized environment, there is also the reason of infection, or there is also risk factors for children. And sometimes risk factors for older adults, if they have a weakened immune system. And a person's immune system is matters, because when a person's immune system is very poor condition, then there is risk factors for infection of intestinal worms. And according to WHO, there is also developing the world are infected with intestinal worms, and people, those who are in developing countries, they have highest risk due to contaminated drinking water, and because of lack of drinking water sources, and also because of decreased sanitation level. They are not maintaining proper sanitized or hygienic environment for staying and for maintain a healthy life. And then we will discuss about further the diagnosis or how we can diagnose that if a person have intestinal worms infection or if a person is suffering from any intestinal worms infection related diseases, how we can diagnose that person or how we can prescribe or how we can take medications for that. If you have any of the above symptoms and especially if you have traveled out of the country recently, you should make an appointment with your doctor. If you have any type of symptoms from these symptoms, and if you are suspected or if you are thought that you have intestinal worms infection, then because of you traveled any out of the country recently and from your travel history, you have to contact with your doctor or appointment with your doctor through which you can properly diagnose your health problem or your issues, how their symptoms are in your health. Your doctor may then carry out an examination of your stool. It may take several stool samples to confirm the parasite's presence. And the doctor can carry out any examination from your stool, and also it can take several stool samples, and through which we can confirm what type of parasites presence in our body and what type of health problems or which disease occurred in our health. And another test is the Scotch tape test, which involves applying tape to the anus several times in order to retrieve Pinome X, which can be identified under a microscope. And there is also another test which is Scotch tape, and we can identify this under a microscope. And if worms or eggs are not detected, your doctor may carry out a blood test to look for antibodies your body produces when it's infected with a parasite. And also from antibody test, we can know which type of intestinal worms or which type of parasites infected our body. And if there is impossible the study by microscopic, we can test through blood test also. Additionally, your doctor may take an X-ray or use imaging tests such as computed tomography or CT scanning, magnetic resonance imaging or MRI, depending on the extent or locations of disease suspected. And also the doctor can may take any X-ray or any CT scanning, MRI, and which depends upon the locations of the disease where the person is suspected and which depends upon the area of that person's condition. Treatment. What are the treatment for intestinal worms or when a person is suffering from intestinal worms infection, then through which treatment we can prevent or we can cure the intestinal worms infections? Some types of intestinal worms such as tapeworms may disappear on their own if you have a strong immune system and healthy diet and lifestyle. If you can maintain healthy diet or healthy lifestyle, or if you are a strong immune system, then you can fight with the intestinal worms such as tapeworms and other worms also. Next is, however, depending on the type of intestinal worm infection, one may require treatment with an antiparasitic medication. Serious symptoms should not be ignored, and if there is any type of serious symptoms, then don't ignore these symptoms, and which depending on the type of intestinal worm infection, and if one may require treatment with any antiparasitic medications, then properly prescribed or contact with the doctor and follow the doctor's prescription through which you can get proper treatment. See your doctor if you have blood or force in your stool, and contact the doctor immediately if you have blood or force in your stool. Then are vomiting daily or frequently? If you have regularly vomiting or frequently vomiting, then contact with your doctor. Have an elevated body temperature. If your body temperature is not constant, then contact your doctor immediately. And this is also treatment of a person which person is suffering from intestinal worms infection. And also contact your doctor if you are extremely fatigued and dehydrated. At that time also you have to contact with doctor. And next is your treatment plan will be determined based on the type of intestinal worm you have and your symptoms. And the prescribed or the prescription of doctor always depends upon the which type of intestinal worms infected your body and what are the symptoms you have. The treatment plan always depends upon that. Tapeworm infections are usually treated with an oral medication such as praziquantel, which paralyzes the adult tapeworm. And also tapeworm infections are usually treated with the medications which we are taken orally, and praziquantel medicines, and which paralyzes the tapeworms when the tapeworms are in adult period. The praziquantel causes the tapeworms to detach from the gut, become dissolved and then pass out of your body through your stool. And when a person is taking the praziquantel medication which causes or which cures the tapeworm, and these medications detach the tapeworm from the gut, and this tapeworm dissolved in your body, and it can pass out through your stool. Next is common treatments for a roundworm infection include mebendazole and albendazole. These are the medications for the roundworm infection. If you have any type of symptoms or if you have the problems due to intestinal worms infection, it can improve after a few weeks of treatment. When you are taking treatment or when you are taking medications and follow the prescription of doctor, after few weeks of treatment, you can feel cure or you can feel better from before when you are infected by intestinal worms and you have no treatment. Your doctor will most likely take and analyze another stool sample after treatment is complete to see if the worms have disappeared. And also the doctor will taste your stool, and also the doctor can taste blood sample also after treatment. And when the treatment is complete, the doctor will taste your blood and the stool also for see or if the worms have disappeared or dissolved or not in your body. And next we will discuss about what are the complications or life-threatening situations when a person is suffering from intestinal worms infection. Intestinal worms increase your risk for anemia and intestinal blockages. When a person is infected by intestinal worms, there is also increase your risk for anemia and intestinal blockages in your body. Complications occur more frequently in older adults and in people who have suppressed immune systems, such as people with HIV or AIDS infections. And also there is complications occur when older adults and in people who have poor immune system, and when persons are suffering from any other disease like HIV or AIDS infection, there is major complications for them. Intestinal worm infections can pose a higher risk if you are pregnant. If you are pregnant and are found to have an intestinal worm infection, your doctor will determine which antiparasitic medication therapy is safe to take during pregnancy and will monitor you closely while you are treated during pregnancy. And mainly at the time of pregnancy, there is no medications for them. And when a mother is infected by intestinal worms infection, and it can pose higher risk for pregnant women because the doctor will test different antiparasitic medications therapy for the woman, and it will monitor closely because of their pregnancy period, very serious period, and in which period there is the other medications are not applicable for the mother. And next is what are the preventions. To prevent intestinal worms regularly, wash your hands with soap and hot water before and after using the toilet and before preparing or eating foods. When you are preparing or eating food, then you have to regularly wash your hands with soap and hot water also before taking or before and after using the toilet. You should also practice food safety, and you have to also practice food safety, like avoid raw fish and meat. You have to avoid to take raw fish and meat, thoroughly cook meat to temperatures of at least 145 degree Fahrenheit or 62.8 degrees Celsius for whole cuts of meat, and 160 degree Fahrenheit or 71 degrees Celsius for ground meat and poultry. You have to cook meat in that temperatures through which you can take proper food, and you have to cook food in very process or systematic way. Let cooked meat rest for 3 minutes before carving or consuming, and you have to let cooked meat rest for 3 minutes before consuming this meat. Freeze fish or meat to -4 degree Fahrenheit or -20 degree Celsius for at least 24 hours, and you can freeze fish or meat at least for 24 hours, not more than 24 hours. Wash, peel or cook all raw fruits and vegetables. When you are taking food or fruit, when you are cooking, then you have to wash or peel or cook the raw fruits and vegetables very systematically. Wash or reheat any food that falls on the floor. If you are taking any food which has fallen on the floor, then you have to wash or reheat that food. If you are visiting developing countries, cook fruits and vegetables with boiled or purified water before eating, and avoid contact with soil that may be contaminated with human feces. If you are visiting any developing countries and you are taking fruits or vegetables, then if you have to take these fruits and vegetables with boiled and purified water before eating, and you have to avoid the contact with soil which is contaminated with human feces or which is contaminated with any type of intestinal worms. This is all about today's lecture. In this lecture, we had discussed about the intestinal worms. What are the symptoms? What are the causes of intestinal worms infection? What are the precautions for intestinal worms infection? What are the treatments and diagnosis for prevent the intestinal worms, and what are the complications when a person is suffering from intestinal worms infection? We can know all about the intestinal worms from this lecture. If any query, then you can ask me through comment box. Have a great day.